When I'm underneath the bright lights, when I'm trying to have a good time, cause I'm looking at you ain't mine, nah, 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 don't call me at home, when you're looking at my photos, getting hot, losing control, you want me more, nah, let go, nah, 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 I'm over here, I don't need your lights no more, cause the truth is that you boy, you're stronger, and I know, yes, I don't call me.
I could hear this song every day forever and still really like it. This one and like Shut Up and Dance. There's like a couple I could always, always hear and love every single time. Erica, I see you on here. Okay, so we can go no matter what. Erica's on, so we're good to go. All right, I'm going to turn off Justin, and it's a sad moment here, but we're going to turn him off for a minute. Also, those of you that have Netflix, first of all, how many of you watched the Beyonce's Homecoming? Have any of you watched it? You know what's so great about it? First of all, do you all have Netflix? Like, who are you? It's like talking to my YMCA class. I'm like, have you heard that a Taylor Swift song? And they're all looking at me like you're speaking Chinese. Like, pop culture, people. Come on now. Get into it. So I watched Homecoming last night. And, I mean, I'm not a huge, huge Beyonce, like, music fan. I like some of her songs, but not all of them. But, y'all, you have to go watch that for the sheer inspiration of the work that went into that Coachella performance. It is unbelievable. And you've probably heard, like you've seen the meme or seen it on Instagram or talk about, you know, like 10, 12 months she worked on this, you know, performance that she did two weekends. But what's so cool about it is that she also had just had the babies. So she not only is recovering, you know, as a had these twins and is a new mom and has three kids, but then she committed to Coachella. So she's getting her body back in shape. She's putting together this ginormous show, and the work ethic and the drive behind it, so inspiring. So if you have Netflix, I highly suggest that you go watch it for that. It's super good. And then when you get done with that, like right next to it, if you search like musical things, is Justin Timberlake's 2020 tour. So I just highly suggest you go watch that as well, mostly because it's just Justin Timberlake like in a suit and tie. Yeah, it's so good. So go watch that. And then Taylor Swift Reputation, if you're in the musical mood, is all. Those are my recommendations tonight for a Sunday night. So we're going to get started. As you know, we did not have a team call last week for Easter Sunday, but in 2 weeks, it's Mother's Day, and yes, we're still going to have a team call. My husband's like, really? I go, yes, really. You know why? Because we are CEO moms, and we are building multimillion-dollar businesses, and after we have breakfast in bed and do whatever, we're done with our children anyway by 7 p.m., and let's just be about our business. So yeah, we're going to build a business on Mother's Day at 7 o'clock, so we will still have one on Mother's Day, and we have just tapped into the amazing leadership that we have right here on this team for the next several weeks. Incredible content and calls coming to you with their own presentations. They're bringing people on as guest speakers. It's going to be really amazing. So we got some really great stuff coming for the next few weeks leading us into the summer. And then we'll take a little bit of a break and then ramp it up again for Summit. So got really great tools coming your way. And that's why these team calls are so important. This is the place where we tap into our tribe, where we learn about new tools, where we stay connected. You know, a long time ago when I first started 11 years ago, there was a coach who had been in it just a little bit longer than I had, and he kept using the term stay close to the fire. His name's Tommy Migrant. He won the Beachbody Challenge 1 year, and he always used that term, stay close to the fire. And sometimes it's kind of like a live event. Sometimes the fire needs your energy to stay hot, and sometimes you need the fire's energy to stay hot. But either way, if you disconnect from the fire, in this case, the team, then your business, your life will suffer. It just will. You have to stay connected to the fire. So we're glad that you're here tonight. Thanks for showing up with a coachable spirit, for taking the time to make sure that you are staying connected to the fire. We have a great speaker tonight in Erica Buzzard, one of our very own, who's going to lead us. And I have no idea what she's talking about, and it doesn't matter because it's going to be awesome. So a couple items to cover, some housekeeping stuff to cover before we turn it over to Erica. One is the Rise to Diamond group does start tomorrow. I have been, the majority of my day today has been emailing, answering questions, checking the Google Doc, approving requests, blah, blah, blah. And that ends tonight, my friends. So I've been getting a lot of questions from people about, well, I just had Success Club 2, but why are you telling me I can't get in? Because how do I know that you have Success Club 2 unless you go update the Google Doc? I don't know how to know that. I can't read all of your minds. So if your situation has changed and you are able to participate in the Rise to Diamond group by either elevating yourself to Emerald or putting points on the board for Success Club, you need to go update that Google Doc. You are the CEO of a multi-million dollar business, and I am not your mom. So you have to go update that Google Doc so that I can then send you the information, and I will make one more sweep through tonight of people. So if you're not updated by tonight, you're going to have to wait till the next time. It's a hard shut off tonight because Trina and Christina and I have big teams, and we want to serve those people that have already committed in it, and we can't be letting people in tomorrow. So anything that needs to be updated has to happen today, and then those last invitations are going out tonight, and it's going to be really awesome. This group's going to be really awesome. Trina and Christina and I are super excited about it. So for those of you that are in it, get ready. It's going to be great. So that starts tomorrow. A great national wake-up call tomorrow with a 5-star diamond. I love that we are really leveraging some of those 5-star, 6-star, 7-star diamond coaches. Not everything is about, you know, 25-star diamond coach. I love the last few national wake-up calls that we've had, so make sure that you're tuning into that. And last but not least, you may have seen it in the team email that went out today. So first of all, I don't know if you've been on the team page like this week, but I have been moved by the spirit this week, and I have been in our team page with some Facebook Lives, and tonight I'm calm. I'm not feeling as moved by the spirit tonight, but one never knows by the end of the call what might take over and happen. But this week I have been moved by the spirit, and it's just been, you know, there are those moments in your life when you're like, dude, what are we doing? Why are we just sort of like putting along here so complacently. What is happening? And I think that's kind of what happened this week. And I'm just sort of over it. And I threw out a challenge to some of my leaders for Success Club 30 and 31, hashtag 30 and 31. So you may have seen that in the team email. 30 and 31, Success Club 30 in the 31 days of May. Because the bottom line is, we as coaches connect people with solutions that work. We help them get results with those solutions. That's what we do. And we are CEOs of a multi-million dollar business. Every business has a metric. The metric in our business is Success Club. So if we're not achieving Success Club, we're not doing our job as coaches. There is zero point in attaching drama or emotion or excuse or anything else to that. That's just hard, cold fact. If we're not achieving Success Club, likely we are not doing our job as coaches, which is connecting people with solutions at work and helping those people get results with those solutions, period. There's no need to dress it up or make it anything other than that's what it is. And I was just sharing with some other coaches that back in the day, I used to work at the Limited, which I don't think exists anymore, but I did work at the Limited and had all the Limited clothes. And when I worked at the Limited, if I would have in 1 month sold three items of clothing, only three, a sweater, a skirt, and a shirt. If I would have sold three items of clothing at the Limited in 1 month, do you know what would have happened to me the next month? I would have been fired. If I would have sold three items of clothing in a month. And that's what we're doing by saying Success Club 5 is kind of where we are. Or it's what we're doing if we're not even hitting Success Club. We're saying, well, I'm working retail, but it's okay that I don't sell anything. No, it is not. Because what we do as coaches is connect people with our solutions that work and we help them get results. So I've thrown out a challenge for May, and that is Success Club 30. Let that sink in for a minute. Success Club 30. Because what we do, one more time for the people in the back row, is connect people with solutions that work and we help them get results with those solutions. So why, as a coach, would we not want to connect more people with our solutions that work? Because hands down, no question, 100%. If you are on this call tonight, likely you have a rock solid belief in our products and programs, and why would you not be sharing that with more people? Because you have no question in your mind that Insanity Max 30 works, or Ultimate Portion Fix works, or 21 Day Fix works, or Transform 20 works, or 80 Day Obsession works. You know that those programs and products work and get results. So why not share them with more people? So that's my challenge to you, Sparta Nation, because why the heck not? Why not go after 15 new people on your teams as coaches in your challenge groups? Why not set the bar a little higher? Why, instead of, you know, maybe hitting success of 2 or 4 and going, well, I tried, why not say, no, actually, I haven't tried. Actually, no, I haven't really tried. I've made a lot of excuses and I've scrolled a lot on Instagram, but I actually haven't really tried. And how about in May, we try? And we go for Success Club 30. You might surprise yourself and hit Success Club 50. And then what would happen? You just set a new bar for yourself. Or you might, for the first time ever, just hit Success Club 20. And how cool would that be? But either way, it's a win. Success Club 6, success, you know, 3 people, Success Club 5, that's awesome. But that's just the basic. That's just the foundation. If I would have sold 3 items of clothing at the Limited in a day, I would have been fired. Why don't we raise our own standards a little bit more? Why don't we ask ourselves, as I shared in the team page earlier this week, how good do we want to be? Because that answer, that potential is unlimited. So my challenge to you for May is Success Club 30 in 31 days. Can you do it? Yes, you can, if you make a decision around it and then take action. Can you make a whole lot of excuses and spend time scrolling Instagram? Sure, you can do that too, but chances are some of us are already doing that. So why don't we try something different in May? And let's go after it. And let's find those people who need what we have, because there are 1 billion people in this world. So many of them have no idea that fitness and health don't have to be hard. They think it has to be so hard. It doesn't. And we know that, and we have the answer. Let's find them. Let's bring them into our tribe. Let's make them part of our community. Let's help them understand that health and fitness doesn't have to be hard, that they can get results, and maybe they can help change others' lives too. So if you're in for that challenge, I would love to see you drop hashtag 30 and 31 in the comments. And if it freaks you out a little bit to think about Success Club 30, acknowledge that, but then really ask yourself why. Why would it freak you out to help more people? Shouldn't that excite you and energize you? Like, when I think of the possibility of bringing 15 new coaches onto my team, like, that sets me on fire. And I hope it does for you too. So get over yourself, get out of your head, remind yourself of what we do as coaches, and remind yourself of how these products and programs have changed your life. And now let's go after it in May. 30 and 31. Because what's the worst that we can that can happen? We help a few more people. I think that's pretty cool. What an amazing way to set ourselves up for summer. So that's our challenge. And I hope that you will hashtag 30 and 31 and join us. And I'm sure that I'll have to come up with some sort of graphic or t-shirt or something to put in the team page to go after. And speaking of, what do you think of the new team logo? Like, y'all, I am in love with it. It's going to be everywhere. I love it so much. I'm so happy about it. Evolution. Everything is about evolution. Team logo's gone through a couple iterations, a couple evolutions, as should we. We should not be the same person that we were when we started coaching, that we are today. It'll continue to evolve. So, okay, Erica, I'm going to turn you on speaker view, as should everybody, so that we have Erica filling our page. I'm going to mute myself and turn it over to you.
Hi, you guys. Happy Sunday. Can you guys hear me okay? Give me some thumbs up, some spirit sprinkles if we're all good in the hood here. Yay. Well, I just have to say that as people were popping on, I was looking at you and just thinking, wow, we have a very good looking team. Like, you guys are killing it. I was trying to get ready for the call and I'm like, do I wear a braid? Do I wear my headband? Like, and I'm just messy bunning it. Why? Because you guys, it's time to put some work in tonight. And I'm so freaking excited. Julie invited me to speak tonight. And of course I said yes. And it's funny because she's like, well, you can also, you know, you can also coordinate a speaker if you'd like to maybe have a guest or somebody else, like, totally up to you. And I'm like, no, mama's speaking tonight. And I'm so excited to share this message with you guys. I always get so much joy out of being in a position to teach and share best practices. And it's really just an honor to be with you guys tonight. And so for those of you who don't know my story, you guys, I've been coaching for 6 years, and hands down, best 6 years of my life without comparison. And the thing that's crazy is my babies weren't even born in those 6 years. But of course, when my babies were born, it was like the best time of my life. But you guys, what is so special about this business is that we get to decide exactly how the story is going to go. And as Julie was talking about some of her Netflix suggestions, I was like, oh my gosh, she's going to say it. She's going to say it. And she didn't say it, which I'm actually glad, because I'm like, oh, cool, now I can still say it. But Brené Brown on Netflix, I don't know if you saw this, but Julie's nodding her head. Yes, I see some of you guys nodding your head. I'm like hugely obsessed with Brené Brown. My background is in psychology. I was a psychology high school teacher for 6 years before becoming a coach. And there was some overlap time there when I was coaching and teaching at the same time. But love me some Brené Brown. She has basically a presentation. It's like an hour and a half on Netflix called A Call to Courage. So freaking good. And I always share this every time I speak to my team, because it's so incredibly important for us to remember this. And if you guys have read her book, Brené Brown, Daring Greatly, then you've heard of this, but I'm going to read it to you. It's not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and blood and sweat, who strives valiantly, who errs. We can relate to that. Who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming. Let me repeat. There is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least he fails while daring greatly. And you guys, that's what this call is about tonight. We're going to talk about how the heck can we dare greatly. And I see some babies, so I'm going to keep it G-rated. But how do we dare greatly? How do we get in the arena? Maybe we just signed up for coaching yesterday, or we've been in this business for 6 years like me, and you're like, it's time for me to get in the arena. How do I do that? That's what I want to talk to you guys about tonight. How do we step into the arena and be proud to be in the arena and shake all the haters off and just live each day knowing that we're going to face naysayers, knowing we're going to face critics, knowing we're going to fall and stumble and be hit in the face, but staying in the game. So you guys, when I watched Brené Brown this week, and I'm like, this is perfect, you know, because I love sharing this, and I love this message. And that is actually by Teddy Roosevelt, and she speaks about a little bit more in depth in her book about this. But let's talk about getting in the arena. So there's three things that I'm going to talk to you about tonight. And you guys, I truly like was debating, do I do a PowerPoint? Do I do this or that? I'm just going to talk to you. And so I'm going to talk to your hearts. And then I'm also going to ask that you take notes, because I'm going to super fire, quick speed, rapid fire stuff at you. And you got to be ready. So get out your notebook if you don't have it ready. I'm also a little later, just to prepare you so you know what's coming, going to do a screen share so that I can actually share my phone screen. And I'm going to show you some of my busy coach hacks, some of my shortcuts, and some of the things that helps me, a busy mama of 5 kids, 2 11-year-olds, 2 8-year-olds, and a 4-year-old who are all in things and sports and actually go to 3 different schools. I'm going to tell you how I've been able to make coaching work despite all the busy and all the crazy, okay? So let's talk about heart, because I'm going to talk to you about 3 things tonight. Number 1 is heart. Number 2 is plan of attack. And number 3 is hustle. So let's talk about heart here. You guys, what I want you to understand more than anything is this business requires you to love it. You have to love it. If you don't love this, it's not going to work, because people can see through that. If you're not genuinely passionate and authentic and believe in Beachbody and bleed Beachbody blue, as we like to say, people read right through that, you guys. You have to love this. And guess what? Here's the super cool part. If you're saying like, Erica, you know, I don't really love it. You need to fall in love, and it's your choice to fall in love. You get to decide how big your heart is for this. And that is the most beautiful part of this. You get to decide the story you're telling for yourself and to yourself and to the world. Let me tell you a little story about myself. So when I first signed up for coaching, I was so green. I knew nothing about business or anything. I mean, I just was like, this is cool. And Erin is my upline coach, and she was, you know, telling me all about it. I was like, this is awesome. But I had no idea what I was doing. And I was like, oh my gosh. So Emerald, okay, I'm going to get to Emerald. And then once I got to Emerald, I was like, oh, I got a Diamond. I want to go to Diamond, but like, I need, you know, 8 coaches, and 2 of them have to be Emerald. And oh my gosh, I need 8 coaches, and 2 of them have to be Emerald. Like, how in the beep am I going to do that? And I remember thinking how scared I was to talk to people about coaching. Like, I literally was like shaking in my boots. Like, I didn't know how to say it. I didn't know. I was like thinking about, oh my gosh, what if they say yes? Then I can, you know, be 1 step closer to Diamond. But the whole time I was thinking about it from my perspective. I was thinking, what happens if they say yes? What's that going to mean to me? How am I going to be positively impacted by that yes? And that was my mindset for a lot of months, you guys. I was an Emerald for a whole year. And I don't tell you that to excuse yourself out of hustle. I tell you that because honestly, my mind wasn't even on what other people could gain from this. It was all, what can I gain if I add coaches? Okay, do you guys understand the difference between those two mindsets? Well, then when I became very, very open to receive, and I flipped the switch in my head and I said, you know what? This business changes lives. My life, and at that point as an Emerald, is forever changed because I've made myself a priority. I've figured out fitness. I'm not just going to the YMCA on the elliptical and like scrolling MySpace. Y'all remember MySpace? Okay.
And I like have a community and I have people that care if I show up, and like I have this opportunity to like earn a little bit of money. And at the time it wasn't a whole lot of money, but it was money. And I was like, this changes lives. And if I always come from a place of help, and if I see that that coach can have this transformation, just like I've had, they can earn extra money for their family. They can have a community. They can have the sisterhood. They can find fitness and Shakeology, and like they can have that too. That's what coaching is. It's not about getting Erica Buzzer to diamond. It's about sharing the blessing. So the moment I flipped that switch, you guys, everything changed. You've got to get out of the center of the universe, and you have to understand that this business changes lives. It does. And it's a blessing. You've been blessed. You are blessed. And you're one of very few people who are this blessed. That's what you have to understand. There's what, 400,000 coaches in the world, and you are one of them. Okay? You guys, if you had the cure for cancer in your hands, would you not shout it from the freaking rooftop like, oh my gosh, I have the cure for cancer. You guys, knocking on doors, I have the cure for cancer. Would you not do that? And Jason's upstairs probably like, what in the hell are you doing? But anyway, if you had the cure for cancer, you would run and tell everybody. You have the cure for something, you guys. You have the cure for loneliness. You have the cure for obesity. You have the cure for diseases and depression and anxiety and hopelessness and financial struggle. You have that cure, you guys. So until you fully embrace and accept that, you won't reach your full potential as a coach. You just won't. But you get to decide right here how much you love this. And every day you work to love it even more, just like you do your babies, just like you do your spouse, just like you do your important relationships. You work to love it even more. That's why PD is so important. That's why doing things to fill your cup. I was talking to my team the other day and I said, you guys understand that if you don't do PD, if you don't do personal development, which is 1/4 of the 4 vital behaviors, you're operating at best as a coach and human at a 75% C level. That's as good as it's going to get ever. Never going to go anywhere above a C level. Is that okay by you? Because it's not okay by me. So think about that. Think about that and make PD a part of your everyday life, just like brushing your teeth, just like brushing your teeth. 10 minutes, 10 pages, 10 minutes, 10 pages, however you like to roll, whether it's audio or a book or whatever, make it a part of your life. Okay? So think about what you love about this. And I'm actually going to ask you to start writing something down, but we're not going to completely do this activity, but I want you to have this so that you can go back after this call and do this and really think about what you love about this. And I've got to give credit to my homeboy, Josh Coates, because it's, again, it's one of those universe things. Just like I, you know, came across Brene Brown on Netflix this weekend. I came across this email from Josh Coates about this. I was like, this is perfect. And so basically we get so wrapped up in other people's stories that we forget we have our own story to tell. We have a story that someone is literally dying to hear, but we don't tell it because we think, oh, it's not as good as Julie's or Aaron's or April's. Like, I just don't have what she has. And I don't, whatever, we could play the comparison game. Okay. But the truth is that you do have a story to tell, and you've got to stop paying attention to everybody else's story because it's actually stealing your ability to share your own. So this is what I want you to do. Take out a piece of paper and draw a line down the center. And again, we're not going to like flesh this out right now, but take out a fresh sheet of paper, draw a line down the center. On the left side is who you were before Beachbody, who you were before coaching. Okay. And on the right side is who you have become since. You can talk about money. If you want to talk about rank, you can. You don't have to. If you want to talk about the people that you've helped, you can. But what I really want you to make sure you think about is who was that person on the left? Talk about who she was. What were her character traits? How did she live her life? Was she excited to wake up every day? Like, what was your life like before? Okay? And dig deep here. Dig as deep as you can go. And then on the right, you're going to talk about who you've become, how you feel. I mean, look at us right now. 65 of us are on here live. when we could be doing 1 million other things, not to mention the people who are going to catch the recording later. You guys, we've made this choice to be here because we believe in it and we want to grow and we want to make an impact. How freaking cool is it that we even have something that is impact worthy? That is really special. So I think about the person I was before, the struggle, the mindset, the loneliness, the busyness, the hopelessness. We probably have a lot in common in who we were before. And we've also probably gained a lot of the same things in who we are now. But think about the rest of the world. Think about all the people out there who don't have community, who don't have this opportunity, who don't have a growth mindset. Okay? Think about that. Don't you think that those people need to hear this message? There's so many people who are like us before. We get to be in a position that takes people from where they are now to where they dream, pray, hope of being. Okay? Think about that. All right, we're going to switch gears because I think that's enough of the heart piece. And I feel you, you're nodding, you're giving me all the signs that you're receiving this, and that makes my heart really, really happy. You guys, you got to have heart. You have to have heart. There's no way I would have made it this far in the business. There's no way Julie would have made it this far in the business. Aaron, I'm looking at some of the vets on here. April, I saw Karen. Ophi, I saw her. Jamie, I see you. There's no way us vets in the business would still be here if we didn't have heart. Heart is essential. Okay. So we're going to switch gears and we're going to talk about plan of attack. Because you can have a lot of heart, but if you don't have a plan, okay, let's talk about Beyonce for a second, since, you know, Julie mentioned her. Beyonce probably is so passionate about music. We know she's passionate about music. She's passionate about performing. She's passionate about women empowerment. But if she didn't have a plan for how she was going to operate or show up, nothing would come to fruition. So when we think about a plan, I love thinking about Sundays. We're all here on a Sunday, and it's so important that you take a day every week and you say, I have to make a plan. I have to make a plan for my coaching business. And I don't care how busy you are. You guys, I built this business. I mean, I care about you. Of course I care about you, but I was so freaking busy when I built this business. First of all, I wasn't even looking for it. I had just nailed in how to take care of myself. So to think that not only did I have two babies at home, was working full-time as a high school teacher with 175 freshmen, but I also was working a second job on the weekends to supplement my income. So for me to take on an extra side hustle was not in the cards or part of the plan at all. But somehow I made it work. How did I make it work? I woke up at 4 a.m., but I loved it. You guys, I woke up at 4 a.m. and I was like, woo, like put me in, coach. Like, this is amazing. Because remember, I had the heart. I had the heart and I knew I had the cure for cancer. And so I was like, I don't care. I'll sleep when I'm dead. And this is a phase. This is a means to an end because this is going to get me where I want to go. This is going to help me help people. And I remember in one of my early months as a coach, I hit Success Club 33. And right now we hear ridiculous numbers. But Success Club 33, back then especially, was like, what? Like, I mean, I remember Julie. I didn't really know her at all. And she asked me to speak on this call. And I was like, what? And I, like, was an emerald, I think. And she's like, well, you hit Success Club 33, so you must be doing something right. Do you remember this, Julie? We'll see if she remembers. But, and I was like, And
I don't, but clearly that was really good leadership on my part. So
you spotted me. You spotted me. You're like right there. So she's like, just do the call. And I was like, okay. But I said yes. I did things that made me a little bit uncomfortable, but also made me feel alive. And I led with my heart. And here's something that I told myself early on that you guys need to write down. I come from a place of help. I'm coming from a place of help. I always come from a place of help. In everything that I do, when I send an invite to my challenge group, when I send an invite to coaching, when I mentor my team, when I do the things, I'm always coming from a place of help. And if you get in that mindset of I'm coming from a place of help, nothing else matters. Okay? It doesn't matter how you're received because you're coming from a place of help. And when some, that'd be like you fall down, you skin your knee, and you come up, and somebody comes up to help you get up. Can I get you a Band-Aid? You know, your babies fall down, skin their knee. Do you need a Band-Aid? Do you want some Neosporin? Are you okay? Can I give you a hug? You're coming from a place of help. You can't do wrong when you come from a place of help. Okay, so back, rewind to when I was a busy teacher, waking up at 4 a.m. because I loved it. I didn't start waking up at 4 a.m. I started waking up 15 minutes early. 15 minutes. I eased into it. Also worked in pockets of time. Today, I'm a full-time Beachbody coach, so I've come a long way. I don't wake up at 4 a.m. anymore, but if I needed to grow this business, I freaking would. I still wake up early. Treat this like a damn business, you guys. Stop treating it like, oh, it's going to fall in my lap. It's, you know, like, people are going to knock on my door. No, they're not. They're never going to knock on your door. Ever. Not going to happen. Not going to happen. Come on, Felicia. This is what I say in my family. Like, Felicia, get it together. Okay? Just like fitness. If we all were, I know we're a fitness-minded team. If we all were to stop working out today, girl, you're going to lose your results. Come check in 2 weeks from now. You're still not working out. Okay? You know, like, it doesn't hang around. You have to keep working it. You have to keep working it. So Sundays, make a game plan. Sit down, take out your calendar, just like you write in your workouts, just like you pencil in, I got to take Johnny to the dentist. I got to go to work at this time. I got to go build somebody else's dream. If you're building someone else's dream, sister, you better make time to build your own. You hear me? We're not building other people's dreams and neglecting our own anymore. All right. So Sunday game plan, you're writing out your social media posts, and we've got all sorts of resources on, you know, ideas for when to post what and that sort of thing. Get your ideas down for your social media posts. When are you going to work your business? When are your power pockets of time? Okay. Just like when you're meal prepping or meal planning, preparation is the battle. It's not just half of it. It is the battle. So you've got to be prepared. You have to sit down. I always aim to do 5 days of Soul Sister Connects. And I'm going to talk about that in just a second, what my Soul Sister Connects entails. But guess what? I eat the frog and I do them every morning, in the morning, boom, when I wake up. Before my kids get up, I have to, because I have to. I like to go all in. I like to have my meditation music. I like to have my coffee and my Himalayan salt lamp. And I like to find my flow. And I'm like, I'm blessing people. Who's ready to receive? I am helping people. I'm curing people. Like, literally, that's my mindset. And I do it 5 days a week. 5 days a week. You can do it 5 days a week. You got to eat the frog, though. This is what I know for sure. And what I mean by that is you got to do it early. I don't know about you guys, but for me, if I don't get my inviting done, it's like a pit in my stomach all day. It's like, oh, no. I haven't done my job. This is what I want you guys to think about with inviting. Were we all not every single 66 person on this call and people catching the recording? How did we come to this business? Did we go knock on somebody's door, or were we invited to it? I could venture to say that 99% of us were invited. Inviting is everything. Let me tell you another little statistic. You don't invite, you're operating at a 75% at best C level in your life and as a coach. You don't do PD or invite, you're operating at a 50% F level at best in life and as a coach. For real, legit. And I'm not saying, oh, I invited last Tuesday. No, nope. You got to invite every day. You got to invite every day. Find people to invite. Find people to invite. Expand your friend list. Go to friends of friends. Go do hashtags. Go to Rachel Hollis on her page on Instagram. Go to her comments. Who's commenting? Felicia from Tampa. Okay, Felicia from Tampa. Let's start talking. Let's become friends. Like, you guys, seriously, it's that simple. You're overcomplicating it. And I know how easy it is to overcomplicate it because I've done it before. Okay? You got to know what you're inviting people to. So the plan of attack that works for me is this week I'm inviting, if you guys follow me on social media, you'll see that I'm shifting out of coach invites, coach info session focus from last week into challenge group focus this week. So all week my social media is going to be focused on inviting to my challenge group. So my social media posts and my stories are going to align with that. What I talk about in my stories are going to align with that. And when I send my invites, they're all going to align with inviting to my challenge group. All next week, all this upcoming week. Okay. Then the following week, I'm going to focus on coaching invites, aligning my stories with coaching. Because for me, I was getting jumbled and I was getting confused, and I'm like, I need a plan that works, and this works for me. Okay. So it gives you this idea that your posts, your stories, and everything is based on your weekly focus, and everything aligns. It feels really good when that alignment happens. Okay. So here's, I'm going to share my screen here in just a second. There's two things I want to show you. So when you're sitting down to plan, so this week I know I'm inviting my challenge group. Living My Best Life Bootcamp is a challenge group I'm inviting to. Going to have a cost conversation because someone's going to ask me how much it costs, and I'm going to build the value and tell them how much it costs. I'm going to need to have a follow-up because I'm going to get crickets from some people, and I want to make sure I follow up. This is all stuff I'm anticipating the needs of what's going to happen. Okay. Because I'm working smarter, not harder. So I literally go in, and I'm going to do a share here, and I'm going to share my phone so I can show you guys this. I have to like slow down and think so that I can press the right buttons. Okay. So yes. Okay. So, this is awesome. Okay. Can you guys see this? Yeah. Okay. So this is the part when I have to realize, no, you navigate it on your phone, not on the screen, right? Okay. So here in my notes section, I have a lot of notes. Okay. These are all my notes. So knowing that this week I'm inviting to my Living My Best Life Bootcamp. Do you see this right here? Living My Best Life Bootcamp, May 6th. So right here, these are all the invites that I have created, and you really only need one. This is me doing this. This has been my practices for a really long time. Okay. So I have my invite. Hey sister, I hope you're doing well. I'm not sure if you've seen me announce, but I just opened enrollment for my new Living My Best Life online bootcamp. It's easy to follow nutrition plans, meal prep and planning, super fun optional workouts, because at that time I was promoting the optional workout piece, mindset, community and daily support. And we're kicking it off with my 3-day cleanse. Would you want more details? Okay. Now you don't even actually need that many words in yours. I just have a lot of people who have a lot of interest in my 3-day refresh results. So I have been kind of throwing that in. Okay. I have a lot of other examples here. Spring is finally here. Not sure if you've seen me announce. I always direct them to my stories. And I always say, I'm not sure if you've seen in my stories and posts, but because then they're like, I haven't, but okay, let me go check them out and see. I've had a lot of people say that. I haven't, but I'll go look. So I direct them there. Oh, I'll also say something. I know you've been following me for a while, so I wanted to see if now was a better time for you. Would you want more info? Okay. So I've got all of these examples of my invites, and you guys literally make one. It's not hard. Just, it's like, hey girl, how are you? Happy spring. Happy Monday. Happy Sunday. You know, build the excitement. Not sure if you saw my stories. And here's the thing, you guys, you can still say that even if this is going to sound weird, even if like you didn't just talk about it in your story. Like, again, if you've ever talked about it, like with, you know, you kind of have free reign. And here's another kind of gut check. If you are doing your due diligence on your social media. So if I go to Jamie Parsons' social media, can I tell she's a coach? Can I tell she helps people? Do I know that she, loves helping women? You know, is this like something that I can tell from her social media and from her stories and from her posts and stuff? And if the answer is yes, then please understand you've earned the right to invite. If the answer is no, then you might want to do a little bit of work on your social media and send the invite, right? We're still going to send the invite, but you might need to tweak your social media just a tiny bit. Okay. So then I have down here more info. Okay. Because I know that somebody's going to say, okay, yeah, tell me more about it. So here is my more info post.
We clean it up. Good news. We don't have to give up tacos and margaritas. 30 superfood meals are included. A lot of curiosity marketing here. I don't really name drop any specific products. Does it sound like a plan you'd benefit from? Always ending in a question. I always like to throw in results or your money back. We have an amazing money back guarantee. When Aaron told me if I hated Shakeology, I could get my money back. That was honestly, that was the deal that got me to say yes. Cause I thought, well, if I hate it, I'll return it. Seriously. So to me, that matters. And then I have a follow-up here. Okay. So literally make a note because you can copy, paste, copy, paste, copy, paste, copy, paste. I heard somebody say, when you're done with your Soul Sister Connects or your inviting session, and if you're going to hit Success Club 30 in May, you better be ready to invite. You hear me? You better be ready. Just accept it. Don't be weird. Just, yeah, I'm going to do it. I'm going to invite. Like, that's my job. Okay? And I have the same thing. Do you see Bomb Baby Recruiting? And I know I've shared my Bomb Baby invites in Sparta. I know it's there. So it's not, and so don't be like, I don't know what to say. You guys, you know what to say. You know what to say. Okay. Here is what I say for recruiting. Okay. Hey sister, happy Wednesday. Hope you're, I know you can read this, but I'm just reading it out loud too, because I want to. I hope you're having an awesome week. I'm not sure if you've seen in my stories and posts, but I'm expanding my coaching team. As coaches, we get paid. I always say this. We get paid to be on our own health and fitness journey and share it with others. It's the best. I'm hosting a sneak peek into coaching where I share all the details. I cover what coaches do, how we make money, the super fun perks of being a coach on my team. Want to check it out. Why would anybody not want to check it out? I mean, I'm serious. Oh, you get paid to be on your own health and fitness journey? What? I want to do that. So then I have a couple different invites here. Boom, boom, boom. Then sneak peek link. So I have a sneak peek here that Aaron and I and some other, you know, chicks did. And I basically, we recorded it. So now every time someone says yes, I go, boom, here's a sneak peek link. If I don't have like a sneak peek that's like happening that week or something. All right. I tell my favorite parts about coaching. I have the link to the sneak peek. Boom, boom. That easy. That easy. Follow up, coach sign up options, everything's here. Okay, does that make sense, you guys? Like, again, work smarter, not harder. Save a note in your phone with your invite to your challenge group and your invite to recruiting. Boom, done. Okay, now there's one other thing I want to show you that's one of my hacks. Okay, this is my favorite. So I'm going to go to Instagram here and I'll tell you what I mean by, oh, there's my sister. Not the French braid, but the other person. Okay. So this is my Instagram. And what I mean by do a audit of your own Instagram or your own Facebook or your own social media and say like, oh, is this a, like, if I didn't know myself, would I know that I'm a coach? Okay. Yes. I see. Okay. Fitness is her laughter. Okay. If you were to watch the stories, you'd see me talking about everything. Okay. There's okay. Clearly. Yeah. This girl, yep. She's got some before and afters, like, oh, her dog's cute. You're like, see what I mean? Like you can tell like something's going on here. So it's not going to be weird. If I'm again, the invite is like inviting somebody to know more about your business. This is a business. You're a business owner. It's okay. It's okay. You're allowed to be a business owner. If you had a restaurant, you would ask people to come to your restaurant. So don't be weird and just look at this as if it's a restaurant. Okay. Just invite. Okay. So the next thing I want to show you is this. If you go to, now follow me. If you go, hold on a second. Let me go back to my notes and I'm going to pick up my Bomb Baby recruiting invite because I'm going to make it into a shortcut. Are you ready? All right, here we go. I'm gonna copy that, copy. Cause you can just copy and paste, that's fine too. But here's another thing to do. Are you guys following me? Yeah, okay, cool. Let me talk through this. I'm a teacher, I can do better than this. Erica, come on, get it together. Okay, go to settings, boom, settings. Yeah, okay, yeah. Go to settings, general, keyboard. Click on keyboard. Nope, not that one. Sorry. Click on text replacement. That's what it is. Text replacement. Do you see all these? I have a lot. I've already made a lot, but I'm going to show you how I do this. I'm going to make one. Go to plus. My phrase is the invite I just copied.
that I just created, paste it in there. And I am going to call it best life. I'm creating a shortcut for my invite. Save. So now I'm coming here and I'm saying,
Hello,
oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to send some invites. This is Chicky Boone. She looks like a coach. She's a lawyer. That sounds like a good match. Okay. Best life. Well, if I spelled it right. Isn't that what I called it? Best life? There it is. See? It just auto-filled it in. And then send. So where that gets really helpful is when you're working through your Soul Sister Connects. When you are busy and you want to just get your, you know, get your stuff done, which again, if your goal is to hit Success Club 30, you guys have to be smarter. You have to be smarter than you've ever been. How are you going to be smarter? I'm not expecting you to work from sunup to sundown. That's not what we're asking you to do. What we're asking you to do is be smarter. This is how you are smarter. This is how you get smarter. Okay. So that's that. I wanted to show you that. Was that helpful? Did you guys like that? Okay. All right, let's talk about hustle. I don't even know what time it is. I think I have like 12 minutes until it's 8 o'clock. I don't know what the chat section says, but I will read through. And if y'all have any questions, I can share again or answer any questions. But let's talk about hustle. Okay. So you guys, hustle. If you're going to hit, first of all, every single person on this call, it's totally possible for you to hit Success Club 30. It's totally possible for you to sign 15 people up. There's 15 people out there who need what you have to offer. All right. So here's the truth. You're going to hear no. You're going to fall down. You're going to feel like crap. You're going to have days you don't want to do it. The person that you thought was a sure thing isn't going to come through. You're going to stumble. Remember, you're in the arena and it gets messy in there and it's bloody. It is. Remember when Julie was talking earlier this week, I'm loving all of her lives, and she talked about her daughter applying for college. Her daughter knew very well that she was going to face rejection. She knew. She was expecting it. That's how I want you to look at May. I'm going to face rejection. I am going to face it. It's just inevitable. But I'm still going to show up, and I'm still going to do it, and I'm still going to set the goal, and I'm not going to change the goal because I know that I'm going to face rejection or there's going to be stumbles or shortcomings or whatever. Okay, so just accept it and move forward. So it is impossible for you to grow a business without inviting. It is impossible. You can't do it. It's impossible. It's not going to happen. Okay? Think of your invite as an invite to your business, as an invite to, okay, this, you know, I want this person to know more about what I do. I want them to come join a group. I want them to hear about coaching. Like, what if my coach wouldn't have told me about it? You know, I'm looking at my girl, Tammy. She was a lead. She was the lead. If I wouldn't have reached out to Tammy and been like, hey girl, I see you drinking your Shakeology. Like, oh my gosh, I have this amazing Living My Best Life bootcamp. You should totally come check it out. Like, it's just, you know, women doing life together, holding each other accountable, having fun. What if I wouldn't have done that? I mean, seriously, what if I would have said, oh, Tammy doesn't want to hear from me, you know? It's just, it's what we do. It's what we do, okay? So if you're showing up and being consistent, then the invite isn't weird. So that is the action of your business, is the invite. It is. It just is. Like, yes, there's a whole business activity tracker that I definitely think you need to be doing. You need to be tracking your business. You need to have, you know, systems and ways and means of doing anything, of doing the things. But inviting is it. Inviting is it. It is the thing. And so invite on your stories. Invite call to actions. But more than anything, invite in a private message. That is where you are going to find your people. Come from a place of help, and always understand that that person that you're sending that to, you have just given them the cure for cancer. That is what you're doing. Giving them an opportunity to say yes or no, or yes, I want more information. Okay, if you find that you don't know who to invite, Start with who's liking your stuff. Start with who, and you can go back like a few weeks. It doesn't just have to be the post you made yesterday. Go back a few weeks, go back a few months, look and see who is interacting. What's really cool about like Time Hop is you on Facebook is you can see the things that you posted years back and see who was liking and engaging back then. Okay. I mean, that's a great experience too, to see like how terrible you were at social media before, like, oh my gosh. But seriously, who's liking and commenting and who are your friends? And something that I love to tell people is the ABC method. So this is a really great method if you are just like, I want to get my invites out. I want to, you know, reach all the people. And literally you go to Facebook Messenger or you go to your Instagram messages and you type A. And it's going to pop up everybody who has an A and starts with the first, their first name or the last name starts with A. Seriously, if you're doing your job on social media, it's to me, it's not a cold invite if they've said, yeah, I want to follow Jennifer. Yeah, I want to follow Liz. If you show on your social media, I'm a coach, I help people, I promote fitness and laughter and fun and sisterhood, then it's not weird if you're inviting them because they said yes to be your friend, okay? So just get over that right now. And guess what? They can unfriend, unfollow, defriend, defollow, block, whatever, free country. In fact, if that's how you want to react, please do that. I invite you to do it. Seriously, that's the mindset we have. Because I'm in the arena and I've got the cure for cancer. Okay, Felicia, it's time. It's time to work. So ABC method. ABC method. I also, this is the last tip, you guys, and I'm going to be totally done. But the last thing that I do, this is the notebook method. If you guys were at Super Saturday, Super Weekend, you saw Kate Schultes. I love this. I've been doing it all year. And basically, I just take out my notebook and I number 1 through 30. My goal is to get this many in. Okay, this many invites in. And basically, I just write down their name. Boom, 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 boom. Very easy because guess what? I've created my shortcut. I've added my shortcut. I'm doing the ABC method or, you know, taking the inventory of who's liking, commenting, interacting, engaging with me, my new, you know, that kind of thing. Okay. And if they reply back, I highlight, or if they want more information, I highlight them. If they reply back, like if I'm doing just a connect or a happy birthday message, because I do happy birthday messages, then I circle it. Because this person sees me, I saw them, and they saw me in return. So they get a circle. Then once I get to this level with my people, I ask for their email address so I can put them in streak. Okay? Now here's the thing. I do correspond with my emails. I do correspond via email, but what I found is sometimes it gets lost in the shuffle, that gets dumped. I'm like, I'm sending an email from a Gmail account to another Gmail account. Why, Gmail gods, is it going into spam or, you know, filtered in trash? It happens. So if you use email to communicate, you have to follow up, because like 50% of the time they haven't received the message. But it's a really great habit for tracking. It's a really great habit to send out, you know, newsletters and info, and as your team grows and how you keep track of like your leads, like my girl Tammy, you know, like it's smart business. All right. So, and sometimes what I do is I ask for the email so that I can track it. And then I might continue to communicate in the same way that I've been corresponding, just because it keeps it easy, especially if that person's really responsive on IG. There's no reason to cut the cord. Okay. So, that's just a little tip, but tracking, got to track what you're doing too. You got to track what you're doing. And I'm a huge advocate of the business activity tracker. Yeah. Check marks are cool, but you also need names. You need names and you need info, you need data, okay? All right, you guys. So, heart, plan of attack, and hustle. To me, that's how you step in the arena wherever you are today. You rise up with Julie and Trina and Christina, because you guys, I was thinking about this in the shower. This is so weird. Julie's gonna think I'm such a weirdo, but she already knows me, so it's all good. I'm like, this is like Oprah Winfrey, J-Lo, and Ellen DeGeneres having you over, and because I love, those are like my three favorite people on earth, you know, and I'm like, doing a freaking training. That's what you have in this Rise of Diamond. And I want to be in it so bad. I really do, but I can't be in it, but others can. So please live vicariously, or I'll live vicariously through you. You guys, this team is really special. And I hope that you see that you are a part of a movement of people changing lives and caring a whole lot about that. So be proud of what you're a part of, because it's really, really special. And I love you guys so much. I'm going to check out the chat section and see if y'all have any questions for me, and I'll turn it back over to Julie.
Okay, that was amazing. I'm trying to figure out how to get off the speaker view, which every time I try to mess with Zoom,
you, like, shut it down.
That I have issues with Zoom. Erica, that was so fantastic and so perfect for, there we go, gallery view, and so perfect for taking us right into May with this 30 and 31 challenge, because you really highlighted all the components that we should be doing on the daily, but especially if we're going to level up in this next month, you really highlighted those three pieces that we need. You better love what you're doing, and how can you not when you know you're changing lives, but you better have a plan, and then you got to get to work. You got to work that plan. So that encompasses whatever job, you know, it might be. And so for us, we get to have a job where we can wear workout clothes and change lives. I think that's pretty cool. You know, and for the very first time ever in 11 years of doing this, I actually put together an entire month-long posting plan, not just week, but an entire month-long May posting plan. I've never done that before, but it's been a while since I've hit Success Club 30. So why not do something different? I mean, it's been, I don't know, 6 or 8 months or so since I've done that. And my highest that I've ever hit, I think, is 48. Well, I think that'd be really cool to break that. And I've never put together a month-long plan. So why would I not do something different? Think about that in terms of what Erica just shared with you today. If your plan of attack, your plan of action is exactly what you did last week, but yet this week we're trying to level up, then it's probably not going to get you to that next level. If your hustle has been 3 invites a day, but we're trying to level up, then your hustle needs to level up too. It's got to 10X. It's got to be more. So why not try something different? That's the beauty of this business. Just like our team logo evolves, just like we evolve, what we do evolves so that we can get to the next level. If we just continue doing the same old, you're sitting in the same old spot. Period. You know that. You know that. So what an amazing call for us tonight to really kick off May. So if you're not on fire, get out. Bye, Felicia. I just don't even know what to tell you anymore. Also, how cool is my shirt? Like, it's the coolest ever, isn't it? I mean, it's so cool. I don't know. I may or may not be working on something. That's why I'm wearing it. I don't know. But it's so cool. Big thanks to Erica. Oh, wait. Let me get rid of the chat. I want to do a boomerang. I won't capture everyone, because there's 3 pages, but I'll do a boomerang because then we can put it on social. And you know what you can talk about in your social? How cool it is that you're part of a bunch of women who are helping change lives. Isn't that cool? That's what we do. So, okay, like do a or something. Okay, you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, go. Okay, awesome. I shall not be able to tag all of you, but you can go to my story probably and catch it, and make sure that you're putting something on your stories too, so that people that are watching never think, oh my gosh, if I join that, I'm in this on my own. No, you are not. Only if you choose to be. And why would you ever choose to be? So thank you, Erica. Thank you all for showing up tonight. We will see you all next week. Have a great week.